donoru.
You guys told me should be down here.
Let me blow me, but I've told you, I won't even see me.
No,
we found the shoe cam.
We see the whatever.
No, if you're behind me, you'll even know.
Like that.
Yeah, that one.
Before. You have to take an after one.
The after one was here. Your after one.
I'm saying we'll just pass by up.
Thank you.
baby, I hope. Huh? Like a baby.
It sleeps on the mountain.
Only female in the camp.
I'm not.
You're the only female in the camp.
The whole camp?
Yes. You're the only female in the camp. Yes. You're not a female. Huh? Ah! How did, which one? Who?
Oh, okay, he looked like a
How did that Land Mover get here?
Good question.
Look at that. Maybe it's down which cleared the trail, maybe.
That was supposed to be our dining hall, but it's undergoing some renovations. So all of us have to like share like 10 to 15 minutes of one table. That's like three expedition teams per 10 minutes. Beautiful day. The sun is out. Funny thing about this camp, like, there's not really that much views you can get, because it's smack in the middle of the forest. And like in some clearing, like you have a couple of, we're in a clearing of bushes. But to spend another like 1 hour for 20 minutes in the forest before we reach the moorland. As you can see there, the trees are thinning out a bit. So we should be clearing the forest in 30 to 45 minutes. Quite different from our Kenya. But you're not really that high. We're about 2,700 meters. That's pretty low for a fast camp, but it is a 3.5 hour walk from base camp. The first camp on Mount Kenya is about 3,200 meters, which is pretty high up. But it's a nice place. Warm houses, plenty of lighting. Yeah, anyway, see you on camp two, which is Horombo Hut. We spent 2 days there, so I'm pretty excited. Yeah, cheers, guys. Pink jammies.
I know. So, ile tutazunguka?
Eh. Naenda kwa hii. Kama
wewe. Tutazunguka aje? Left.
Mm. Onto the saddle. Just some snow.
Yeah. A little bit.
Sasa, endelea.
That's one of the lyrics.
No, that's the, that it is, that is the main peak. Looks closer than it actually is.
Yeah.
I believe it's 3 days away.
Do you have network? I've had my phone do. But mine, I think, is just those app notifications.
Oh. all over the world, chicken is yummy.
Everywhere in the world.
Everywhere in the world.
Even at 3,000 meters.
Mm-hmm.
Most common food.
Our first lunch break. We're way above the clouds. It's cold. It's like this is cold weather front. It just came out of nowhere. It was really hot. Then suddenly, in a few seconds, pretty cold. Just look at that. That's where you're coming from. That's where you've come from. And the weather is picking up pretty quickly. I think you probably are gonna have to use the gloves. Yeah, you're 2 hours away from Orombo camp, I hope. It's probably going to rain. Hopefully it doesn't snow. It's going to rain. I'm gonna have to put the gaiters and the ponchos on.
This is your presenter once again. Coming to you 3,000 feet above. 3,000 meters actually above sea level.
3,000 meters.
In between the clouds having lunch. As you can see, accompanied by
some Korean friends.
Some Korean friends.
And crows.
We have some crows from, what do you call it?
Which ones?
That move.
Go. It's Kibo.
What are you doing, Pastor?
Mm-hmm. We're approaching Camp 2. Orombo Hut.
An hour.
Record time, too.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful mountain. Way above the clouds. Perfect views. It's crazy.
Yeah, so cool.
Yeah.
So cool.
I'm saying we do a jump shot. We do it now, Cynthia.
So wait, which peak? We're going to that?
Warming up.
Yeah. It's 8 degrees.
You're warming up. You're warming up to go to sleep.
I'm warming up.
To go to sleep.
Because it's 8 degrees.
8 degrees.
Because it's 8 degrees.
Chris,
going to
show us that 8 degree thing.
The temperature.
Temperature.
Ah, switched off.
What were you on?
Yeah.
What were you on?
Where
was it?
Me.
I'm going to reduce my weight.
Okay.
Again. It's the fourth time.
Na wewe?
Mimi niko sawa.
Uko sawa. Kabisa.
Kama shot kamoja ninge.
Hiyo vodka iko wapi? Hiyo changa.
Vodka na maji moto.
It's only a third left.
Yeah, kuna hopes that yet to come.
All right, now let me show you guys what people have been writing in this thing.
Quick. How you have a small dick.
Really small.
It's so very small that you can't even see it at all.
Okay. So it's hard as a bitch, cold, long and endless. We all smell like shit, look like shit and really need to take a shit. But in all, it was great. Very important.
2009.
That light?
What the hell is this about?
You are side bitch.
On the side of a side beach. On another hand,
yeah.
I'm sure if you understand.
Kabi mimi nimetembelewa. Very important.
Good morning from 3,700 meters. You can see it's a beautiful day. Way above the clouds. Above the clouds. You can see the mount, the two peaks. There's Mawenzi. And there's Kibo where the summit is. Yeah, it's gonna be a tough. Tomorrow evening is going to be really tough. Here we are, Horombo camp. Pretty cold. Not really windy, but pretty cold. We didn't hit negative degrees, but we survived, yeah. It's pretty beautiful, clear skies. A lot of the mountain climate, mountain vegetation. You can see the cactus. I don't know what the name is, but the cactus is there. All adaptive to the climate. Yeah. 3,700 meters. Today we're going to do an acclimatization hike up 200 meters to a place called Zebra Rock. Then come down, have lunch, and have a relaxed evening till tomorrow. I mean, everybody is dreading tomorrow because of the. You're not gonna really have some much of sleep, but just a few hours rest. Then we do our summit bid from Kibo Hut. I'll keep you updated as we go. Yeah, good morning. Let me go wash up. Horombo Hut.
Good morning, Terry.
Good morning, too.
Mom, kafe ma?
Kabisa, kabisa. Ready for round
three. How was the night?
Cold.
Cold.
But manageable.
But manageable. Good. Keep umetoroka. Utaki kusema kweli.
So watching your show also.
Yeah, you fresh.
I'm fresh for the camera.
Ah, yes, so.
Watch out.
So the route for Mawenzi is which one? So they start their summit from here. Their summit. They live here. Oh, is that?
Very windy day on Mount Kilimanjaro today. 80 kilometers per hour winds. It's crazy. Literally blows the wind out of you. Today we are doing this summit push. We have a 5 hour walk to summit, hopefully. I'm just praying for these winds to die. This is too much. It's pretty cold.
Unfortunately, we're the last people on the mountain, trying to hurry up back down before the weather closes in. Just thank God I made it. Hardest things I've ever done in my life. Thanks to this guy. Very patient guy. Stuck with me till the end. Had this craziest wave of exhaustion. I don't know where it came from. Walking for 12 good hours. It's crazy. So I'm trying to walk down the mountain. See, we're still above the glaciers. Weather is closing in. Hopefully it's not an emergency. But definitely I'm knackered. Live life. And tell him, this is what you miss. Then I showed him the tembea sticker. I put a tembea sticker on the board. And I had a tembea shirt. Like, I showed it, like...
It was too small. You were there on an agenda, eh?
Sindio!
Yeah, a mission.
No, it was on a mission, bana. You know that guy was telling me, I told him, fungo yo bag nitole shati. Shati? Fungo tu nitole shati. Then he's seeing a shirt fit for a baby. Unda kuvaa yo shati? Apana, wewe nishiki hapo nipige picha. Then I was alone, like you could do whatever you
want.
And it was bright.
Nani leka mob.
And then by like 10, 9:30, 10, 11, it was just so bright. The glaciers were like,
everything was reflecting.
Yeah, light. You had to wear like shades.
Cheers, Timuru.
Successful Uhuru peak.
Kilimanjaro.
Kilimanjaro.
Conquered. I know.
One path anyway.
Hey, the path. We have used the path. The path. The only path. Which is challenging. You don't think there's another. Unless. Morning, fellas. Guess what? I made it to the top. As you can see from the videos, I made it to the top. I'm still fucking chuffed about it. It's probably one of the hardest things I've ever had to do in my life. I mean, it was crazy. A lot of chances for me to give up. A lot of chances for me to turn back. But you know, I promised myself I'm gonna get there. At least on 2 feet or 4 feet, I'm gonna get there. But it was hard as hell. I mean, dude, walked for 12 freaking hours. We left the camp at about 11 o'clock. I reached the summit at about 11 a.m. Yeah, left camp at 11 p.m. 11:30 p.m. Summited at 11 a.m. through fucking wind. I mean, it's crazy. Luckily we didn't have any snow up there, man. Like, there was snow, but it wasn't snow, you know, no blizzard or something like that. So I'm back at Horombo camp, as you can see, in a beautiful hut. Yeah, as you can see, much better than Kibo, man. Kibo is a shithole. It's a shithole, man. Like, I would not wish that on my worst enemy. You can only spend like a few hours there. You can't sleep there. There's no oxygen. You're gonna need to carry some oxygen with you. Otherwise, your chances of dying are pretty high. So, apparently, I messed up my legs. I can't walk for shit. Yeah, I can't stand for shit. I think they call that absolute exhaustion. Like, you can't just do anything. You're tired with like a week's rest. So the rest of the guys have left me. They're going back to base camp. So I'm still stuck in the room waiting for the rescue vehicle. You'll see somewhere in there. I have a screenshot of the ride I came down with from Kibo. It's some kind of a bicycle thing, like a stretcher with one wheel with a motorcycle tire on it. With some shock absorbers, so they kind of strap you in, put you in your sleeping bag, and away you go. Apparently 6 people push it, and it's pretty handy. I mean, it's pretty nice. I mean, I got here in no time. So yeah, I'm coming from here, from Horombo camp. I love it here. I mean, it's much better than Kibo. The air is fresh. I mean, it's still thin, but we're at 700 meters, but it's much better than Kibo. Kibo is like you're breathing through a straw, man. It's much warmer. I mean, Kibo is cold. It has a cement floor, it's a wooden floor. So I'm just here waiting for the rescue vehicle. I have my bags packed up, everything has been taken down. Just my day bag, my cameras, and yeah, my walking stick. So see you get at base camp, and it was an epic climb. I'll do it in a heartbeat. Not really a heartbeat, but 5 years. Not to do this route though. Oh man. It's a nice route for a beginner, but the last part is just crazy, man. From Kibo to Gilman's Point, it's a killer, man. It's a killer. It never ends. It just never seems to end. But eventually it does, and you get to the top. One foot in front of the other. Shout out to Tembea Africa. We made it to the top. Cheers, fellow. See you at base camp.